Now, let us put together all of them. Okay. We are seeing here 4 control volumes, okay, small control volumes in terms of scale. The first control volume, which takes care of the convective momentum. The second control volume to account for the body force, and then we have 2 separate, some books show these 2 control volumes together, we are shown very clearly separately. The third control volume to represent pressure, surface force due to pressure. The fourth control volume to represent surface force due to the viscous stresses. So, now it is going to be a summary of what we have discussed earlier, putting them all together and deriving the differential, complete differential form of linear momentum balance equation. Okay. So, this step is known to us, the integral momentum balance. And then the right hand side we express in terms of the body force and surface forces. Okay. And now let us write down expressions for all the terms, that is the rate of change of momentum and all these are whatever is going to be written are the convective momentum terms. These are all not new to us, we have come across few times. So, the first 2 terms are due to flow in x direction, second 2 terms because of flow in y direction, the last 2 terms of because of flow in z direction, but remember the second velocity is always x, we are writing momentum balance along the x direction. Okay, now, right hand side we have the body force, so till this we have done already. Now, whatever we discussed in the previous slide, we will rewrite here. This is the surface force due to pressure. So, what we are writing right now is expression for the surface force, first we have written for pressure, which is from this control volume. And now, the surface forces due to viscous stresses from this second or the fourth control volume, you can say. Whatever I have written in the previous slide is just written here. Okay, so first 2 terms are normal stresses, the other 4 terms for the shear stresses. Okay. Now, as we have done earlier, we will divide by delta x, delta y, delta z, okay, and we get the first term for rate of change of momentum per unit volume. And then we have all the convective momentum terms, x momentum terms, first because of flow in x direction, then because of flow in y direction, and then because of flow in z direction. And the body force per unit volume on the right hand side, and these are not new to us. Now, these terms are new to us. We have divided the expression in the previous slide by delta x, delta y, delta z, and this expression we get for the pressure force, surface force due to pressure per unit volume, and then we have the surface force due to the viscous stresses per unit volume. We have 3 terms, and just like we discussed in the last slide, here we have P evaluated at x minus P evaluated x plus delta x. Okay. And what we have here are the stresses evaluated x plus delta x minus evaluated x, okay, because of the different directions. So, until this point all the density, all the variables, density, velocity and pressure, the normal stresses, shear stresses were all average values, though we did not specifically mention. Moment you shrink the control volume to a point, they become point values. Okay. So, when we discussed about the control volume with pressure, this P represents evaluated x represents the average value over that phase. Similarly, this P represents average over value over that phase. Similarly, all these stresses are all average values over the respective phases. Moment we shrink the control volume to a point, making delta x, delta y, delta z 0, all of them become point values. Okay. So, imagine this control volume to become a small point or very, very small volume becomes a point, then all these becomes differentials. We have rho by dou x of rho v x v x, which represents this term, and then similarly along y direction, z direction, because of flow in the y direction, that is z direction. Remember, x momentum is still talking about x momentum only. And right hand side, we have rho g x, okay, and this term becomes minus dou p by dou x, because it is x minus x plus delta x. When you take limit, it becomes minus dou p by dou x. On the right hand side, of course, all these terms, the surface stress terms, become just dou by dou x of tau x x, and then so this represents contribution normal stress, these two represents contribution from the shear stresses, dou by dou y tau y x, dou by dou z tau z x. Okay. Now, also like to mention that, remember when we discussed about this convective momentum, we were very particular about the order in which we wrote the velocity components. We said the second component should be the component of velocity along the direction in which you are writing the momentum balance. So, that is why the second component is, or the second term is, or the second velocity component what you have written there is v x, v x, v x, etcetera, immediately tells you that we are talking about the x momentum balance. The first velocity is changes depends on the direction. So, we have contribution from flow along x direction, contribution from flow along y direction and z direction. So, if you look at the linear momentum balance, moment you look at the second velocity component, and here the second subscript tells you that this momentum balance along x direction. That is why we stressed that on the left hand side we write as rho v y v x and not as v x v y, just to be consistent with that on the right hand side. The second term tells you the direction along which you are writing the momentum balance, and similarly we know that the second subscript represents the direction of the force. So, both are in line with each other. Okay. Okay. So, what we will do now is, we know the significance of each term, but let us put them very precisely, so that you will be able to understand and remember as well. Just writing down the linear momentum balance which we have derived. We know that, of course, if you want formally saying, you will say first term is rate of accumulation momentum and the second term is convective momentum, right hand side gravity force, pressure, viscous stresses. Let us put them very, very formally, I would say, because the left hand side time rate of change of momentum per unit volume. Remember, we discussed this when we derived the differential form of mass balance. In a differential equation, differential balance equation, all the differential balance equations, the units are per unit volume basis. We take the control volume, account for whatever forces or flow, and then divide by delta x, delta y, delta z. So, that makes every term to have per unit volume as the unit. So, this term, the first term on the left hand side, represents time rate of change of momentum rho v x. Because it is rho v x, rho is mass per unit volume. So, it represents time rate of change of momentum per unit volume. We are familiar with mv, d by dt of mv, but what we have is dou by dou t of rho v x. Okay. So, time rate of change of momentum per unit volume. Now, all these terms put together tells you net rate of flow of momentum. I have written momentum here, but represent x momentum for the present case out. That is also important because we always took whatever momentum flow out minus flow in along the respective directions. That is why it is net rate of flow of momentum out by convection. What is by convection? If you have a pipe, if you have stream flowing, then we have discussed that the stream flowing has mass associated with that, it carries a momentum, later on energy and species. That is what we mean by convection. Of course, now it is, when you imagine this convection is over a small region, over a small, shrink this control volume to a small volume, and whatever flow happening in this direction, other x direction, y direction, z direction, that is what I mean by convection over a small region, of course, per unit volume. Second term represents net rate because you have flow out minus in, net rate of flow of momentum out by convection per unit volume. Now, let us come to the right hand side where we have all the forces. First is the body force on the fluid per unit volume, the force acting on the fluid per unit volume, okay, because we have rho gx here, we do not have mass into gravity of rho here. So, body force on the fluid per unit volume, and then next term represents the surface force due to pressure, but how do you formally write? It is net pressure force. Why is it net? Remember, we had pressure was compressive, we had pressure acting like this and pressure acting like this, and then we take the force is net pressure force because of these two pressures acting on opposite faces. That is why net pressure force. Pressure, if you say it is force per unit area, right hand side we have force per unit volume. So, more formal terminology is pressure force, okay. And then of course, on the fluid, remember all our forces are acting on the fluid per unit volume. So, very specifically want to stress this slide because you know the significance based on the derivation certainly, but this slide puts it very, very formally, the statements, words also very clearly. So, net pressure force on the fluid per unit volume, okay. And then of course, the last three terms put together, of course, these forces are all along the x direction, okay. Tells you the net viscous forces, of course, once again we take positive force minus negative force, that is why net viscous force on the fluid per unit volume, okay. So, this is a very precise way of writing the significance of each term in the linear momentum balance. All are per unit volume, and rate of change of momentum term, time rate of change of momentum term. We have been very, I would say, very specific in even writing time rate of change of momentum, and so that you do not confuse between momentum flow and rate of change of momentum, okay. And second term on the left hand side is the convective momentum, net rate of flow of momentum out by convection, once again per unit volume. Right hand side, all the forces per unit volume, body force on fluid, net pressure force on fluid, net viscous force on fluid, okay. And of course, we can extend all this to all the three directions, and that is what we will just write down here. All these three equations which are going to come up along x and x, y and z directions together constitute the differential linear momentum balance equation. Though we are done for x direction, we can extend that to other three directions as well. Okay. So, let it complete. So, as it goes along, you can carefully note how is it being written, okay, that is the x momentum balance. So, dou by dou t of rho Vy, we replace this Vx by Vy. Remember, we said the second velocity or the second subscript represents the direction. So, what is that we should do? Take this equation, take this equation on the left hand side, replace with Vx, second Vx, okay, should be very clear. Second, the velocity which is reckoned as the second, that should be replaced with Vy. Look at the second equation, Vx replaced with Vy. This Vx is replaced with Vy, similarly this Vx and similarly this Vx. What does this represent? This is the convective momentum, y momentum, because of flow in x direction, flow in y direction, flow in z direction. If you clearly understand, you need not even memorize these equations, okay. right hand side we have all the forces acting along the y direction. So, replace x with y, and here we should replace the second subscript with y. Second subscript represents the direction of the force, that is why this x replaced with y, similarly here, similarly here. Okay. So, once you have derived one equation, should be able to correctly replace and write the other direction equations analogously for the z direction equation. Okay. So, when you look at this, all these equations should be able to look at the symmetry in which they are written. Okay. All the rho v x here, rho v x here, rho v x here, of course, here rho v x, rho v y, rho v z. First velocity is and rho are same here, here, here. Second velocity keeps changing v x, v y, v z. Similarly, here we have rho v y, rho v y, rho v y, that is same v x, v y, v z, that keeps changing. If you look at the right side, g x, g y, g z, pressure gradient along x direction, along y direction, along z direction, and here we have dou by dou x of tau x x here, x y here, x z here. Just like we had v x v x, v x v y, v x v z, similarly here x x, x y, x z for tau. Similarly here y x, y y, y z, and then z x, z y, z z. Okay. Because here you are considering three phases, the direction of the phases, three phases are considered. That is why first represents the direction of the normal to the face, that is why we have x, y and z. Second represents the direction of the force, that is why it remains same. Just to compare the differential total mass balance and the linear momentum balance, we will see how do they compare. So, that you know the similarity between the conservation equations, that is the differential form of the total mass balance equation. And then the differential form of the linear momentum balance equation written along the x direction goes this way. So, now if you look at the left hand side, here you have dou rho by dou t, that was representing the rate of change of mass per unit volume. Here you have momentum, x momentum. So, what you have is multiply that term with v x, of course, inside the time derivative. If you take all the convective terms, all these represented the net rate of mass flow, and that had contribution from x direction, y direction, z direction. Now, what we are considering x momentum, so multiply all the mass flow components along the x, y, z directions with the x velocity, so that you get the momentum associated with mass flow in x direction, mass flow in y direction, mass flow in z direction. Okay. Right hand side, of course, for the mass balance it is 0, because our law of physics stated that rate of change of mass for a system is 0, but here rate of change of momentum for a system is equal to sum of forces, that is why the right hand side is not 0. Of course, I have written the viscous force per unit volume and the surface force due to pressure and the body force. Of course, if you look at the sequence here, written in the viscous forces to begin with, that is the first term you have written, then comes the pressure force and then the body force. You will understand the reason later why the viscous forces are written to as a first term on the right hand side. Okay.